How many people have actually seen President Trump wear a mask? How many people have seen some of the leaders that have been talking wearing a mask? Ask the question, why? We breathe oxygen. We need oxygen. We breathe out carbon dioxide. How long would an animal or a human last by just breathing carbon dioxide? Not very long. We need oxygen within a minute and a half, 2 minutes, things start to shut off. When you're wearing a mask, you are inducing a hypoxic injury, a pseudo-hypoxia. There are studies have been done. The point being that when you wear a mask, you are restricting airflow. You are also breathing in more carbon dioxide. So you're creating a pseudo-hypoxic state. But more than that, you're also creating stress because your body is now having to suck oxygen through something that's obstructing the airway. In medicine, in trauma, we're taught three things. When in doubt, go back to your ABCs. Everything's about ABCs. ABC stands for airway, breathing, circulation. And notice airway and breathing, all to do with our ability to respire, our ability to oxygenate. When you're wearing a mask, you're reducing your ability to oxygenate. You're also, because you're throwing your body into that chronic stress, because you're sucking oxygen, you have to suck oxygen through this mask, you're increasing your cortisol levels, which is your stress hormone. Cortisol going up suppresses your immune system. You get into what they call a sympathetomimetic drive. You're driving it further and faster. This is a flight-fight response. This is like having your car in park and stepping on the accelerator. That's what you're doing to your body. So you are throwing your body into an overdrive situation of stress that is now going to create a cascade, a domino effect. Because when your body is stressed, guess what happens? You need more oxygen. If a bear was chasing you, would you be breathing harder? And now you've got something covering your mouth. You think that that's going to create a problem with you to breathe? This is the reason I feel this unexplainable need to tell people, even though they're all around me wearing masks, I just feel like I have to correct them. Not because I'm trying to push an agenda, I just don't want people to be hurt. So this information is important for people to understand. And there's an entire cascade of events that continues from this process forward. Wearing masks has never been established, ever been established to prevent disease. There's no scientific literature for that. When a surgeon wears a mask, it's to prevent the surgeon from spitting, drooling, coughing, sneezing into that sterile surgical field. That's why we wear masks, to protect the patient, to protect the sterile field. When people in the Far East wear a mask, they're doing it so that nobody else gets sick from something that they may be carrying. How many people have actually seen President Trump wear a mask? How many people have seen some of the leaders that have been talking wearing a mask? Well, Dr. Fauci hasn't worn a mask until recently, and then when you saw him wearing a mask, they showed like a bunch of still slides, and he's like this, fidgeting, doing everything else. My point is, again, ask the question, why? The issue at hand is separating us. They have always separated us. We have always been separated based upon our differences of our ethnicity, our creed, our nationality, our religions, our political agendas, our political belief systems, our color of our skin. They have divided us. It's time to forget about the division and understand what brings us together. If you can answer that question, why, for any of these things that are happening, and you can justify it, then fine, then go along with it. But the question, if why, if it's not answerable, if something inside you says something doesn't smell right, if your intuition, your gut feeling, your sixth sense, this is all God speaking to you. Do you understand that? Your sixth sense, that gut feeling, the gestalt that we have, that is the creator communicating with us. It's the source of everything. It's a universal consciousness. I don't care what you call it. It is the same thing that's communicating with us, telling us, beware, something is not right. Ask the question, why?